that's not make on you the party.
Now step up, Beza, and let the people them know what I'm going in the heavy metal world right now.
Right, next album is we're not strangers to doing weird records on this show, but this is right up there when we're talking weird records. The band are called Ghost Bath. This album is out on Nuclear Blast, and it is called Star Mourner. Steve, I'm dying to know what you are making of this record.
So am I.
How would you describe the sound of Ghost Bath?
I guess it's uber dramatic heavy metal. I don't really want to describe it as black metal. I think that would give people the wrong impression, although I have seen them described as black metal. I'm not quite sure that black metal fits the bill, really, but it's quite...
Vocally, maybe, but certainly not musically.
I mean, we'll get to the vocals, I'm sure.
Yes, we will.
Musically, it's quite a vast, expansive version of traditional but doomy metal, I suppose. And
it's elements of that shoegazy sort of thing as well. I think that might be just because it's so easy, because the songs are super, super long. This album is nearly an hour and 20 minutes long. And maybe it's the grooves that you get sucked into, but like while it doesn't fit with that traditionally and sonically, I feel like it fits in with that world. Through that. If they were at Roadburn, I wouldn't be surprised.
No, not at all. Not at all. Not in the slightest, no. I think there's some really brilliant bits of musicianship in this. Again, we spoke with it with the Where Your Wounds album. I really like the keys in this. I think there's some really nice piano parts. I don't know what's going on with the vocals. I mean, I don't know. Do you know?
I think that... No, do you know what? I think that this album... Like, whether you like it or not will be purely down to whether or not you can get on with the vocals. Because this album is so surprising. The way that this album opens for the first 5 minutes, like, literally for the first 5 minutes instrumentally, and then the vocals come in, he's like, what? Like, eh? Where did that come from? Because it's really pretty. I'm going to use the word pretty, even though it a lot of this record is heavy as balls. The first 5 minutes of it is really engaging and quite beautiful.
Yeah.
And then the vocals come in, and it's extreme metal vocals, isn't it? That's the best way to describe it.
Yeah. I mean, I think even that is like toning it down a little bit. Do you know what I mean? It's a wild, weird vocal performance.
So you're the guy of us who's more into weird shit. Do you like it? Do you like the vocals on it?
I don't know. I don't know. When I first heard it, I was like, come on, mate, you're taking a piss. But I quite like that. I quite like that as a feeling.
That's why I'm asking, because you're the one who likes this kind of spiky shit. So I wondered. Yeah. I wondered where you sit with it.
I'm struggling with it. I've got to be honest. I'm struggling with finding a pattern within it somewhere. I can't seem to find any rhyme or reason to the vocals at all. Like, it's not that it's heavy or that it's indecipherable or that it's screechy or anything like that. It's just that
we love all of that shit.
Yeah, it's just that it seems to come at just random intervals. Like, there seems to be literally, it's almost like someone's taking the piss. I feel like someone's gone, they've made this album and they've gone, get your mate in who takes a piss out of our music. You know when someone comes up to you and they go, oh, metal.
Yeah.
It does it.
I know lots of those people.
Yeah. It feels like they've just gone, get your mate to do that for an hour and 20 minutes.
Like, just in case you are not subscribed to our YouTube channel, you want to subscribe just to see Steve's actions and motions while he was making those.
That's what they're doing, it, twats.
They do.
Twats there.
It's weird. It's like fucking, it's like Leatherface turning up in American Beauty. Yeah. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it's like, I mean, Leatherface turning up with a chainsaw in American Beauty. There's so much about this record that I like. And I'm like you. Like, it takes a lot for me to go, come on, man, tone it down. Because I like my extremes. I like my metal to be fucking metal. I like my melody and my pop stuff to be super, like, earworms. And with this, I do kind of get that, all right, mate, like... take it down a notch, because the record's good, really good.
Yeah.
I mean, that the first, like, these have got, there's some seriously long songs, and the longest song on the record is 8.5 minutes and comes in as the third track, and it's fucking great, and there's some really interesting stuff. There's a song called Cherubim later on that has this really melodic, like, heavy as fuck, right? Heavy as fuck, but melodic guitar line. And then you've got, like,
the berserker coming over it. Yeah, I know, I do. I when it first started, because I hadn't heard the last record.
I like it, though. I do like it.
Yeah, and I hadn't, you know, I knew that people were going, oh, wait until you hear the vocals. And so I thought, I mean, you know, man, like, I like Phantomers. I like Mike Patton going, like, but at least there seems to be a pattern to it. Whereas this guy is literally like, I can't work it out. And the thing is again, you know, like, I'll talk going to see Zeelanada tonight and just thinking about making people feel uncomfortable with their music, I think is a fucking cool thing. I'm still too early into this record. I want to like this. Because I think there's a lot to like, and I want to be able to listen to it with a straight face and go to people, do you not understand what he's doing with his vocal? Like, don't be an idiot.
Yeah.
Like, I want to...
Stroking your chin, just going, you just don't get it, man.
Yeah, I want to be able to do that. But I also, I refuse to lie. So at the moment, I'm going to have to give it a few more goes, because, I mean, I've had this for about 3 months.
We've had it for fucking ages.
I've been listening to it for ages, and I still am like, come on. Come on.
I love how English we sound about this. Mm. Come on, mate. Come on. There's no need for that, is there? Yeah. We've all had a drink. Just walk away. Just tone it down a bit.
Come on. Tutting away.
Yeah. So there you go. Ghost Bath, Star Mourner. It definitely deserves your attention, and I think it's super engaging musically, but that vocal is fucking mental. There's no other way to describe it. It is fucking batshit. Ooh, I'm a witch. I'm a witch. Psycho fucking shit.
Yeah. I was listening to it, and Emma came in and just sort of sat next to me on the sofa, and he was like going, and she was like, what the fuck are you listening to? It sounds like someone's having a fucking ingrown toenail removed, but the doctor's like gone in through their bum or something. It's like just really weird.
So I'm really hungover on today's podcast, to let you in on a little bit of a behind the scenes. I was out drinking till 2 o'clock in the morning last night, and we got up this morning and I was doing my last listen. My last listens of the albums from the podcast. My wife was sat on the sofa and just went, you are fucking joking. I'm going in there. Just went into the other room. So that album is out now. It's definitely worth your attention, if only to hear how mad it is. Ghost Bath is the name of the band. I definitely think that there's more to come from this band, but they've got to stop that bloke being an absolute lunatic. Star Mourner is the name of the album.